Good morning to everyone. I would like to draw your attention to the fight information literacy versus fake sites. Yes, it is a hard fight, and we probably cannot completely defeat fake sites, but we can achieve important successes. So I would like to discuss with you what libraries can do to support science and to win at least some battles. Let's start with a look back to 2018. In July 2018, German television broadcast a documentary with the title Fake Science, The Lie Factory. You can still access the film in the media library with English subtitles. A team of journalists has declared a veritable science scandal. This is a science scandal that affects us all, they wrote. An academic illusory world. Increasingly bad or even falsified studies are given the appearance of scientificity that has dangerous consequences. They claimed that more than 5,000 scientists from German universities have published research papers with pseudo-academic predatory publishers, has wasted a lot of public money, and they speak of a disaster for science. One of Germany's leading newspapers, the Süddeutsche Zeitung, published also in July 2018 an article titled Shame Business, Attack on Science. Dubious entrepreneurs pose as specialist publishers and publish the greatest nonsense at a serious study for money. Research by the newspaper and the television shows that researchers, companies, and authorities use the system. In doing so, they not only damage their credibility, but also society. One of the journalists, Till Krause, will hold the keynote speech tomorrow with Markus Behmer. I strongly recommend this keynote to you to experience his point of view and the background firsthand. So what are the facts behind this story? True is that we see an increase of articles in predatory journals from 2010 to 2014. Predatory journals means journals that pretend to have a quality control and a peer review, but have not. But it's also true that predatory articles concentrate on some specific disciplines, mainly biomedicine and engineering. And the production and the proportion of predatory articles compared to the total volume of publications, for example, at the Max Planck Gesellschaft, one of the largest German science organizations, or the University of Bamberg, is very low, below 0.1 promille. Nevertheless, the universities had to react to the allegation that scientists waste public money. How they did this, we see a bit later. First, let us define fake science. One aspect of fake science is predatory publishing. That means publication in scientific journals that pretend to have a peer review within the recognized quality standards, but have not. Fake science also means intentionally fake studies and scientific results, a phenomenon that is very old and at the same time cutting edge. This is just some days ago, in September 2021, another well-known German newspaper, the Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung, published an article about dishonest honesty research. Researchers claim that people provide more honest information on forms like tax returns when they sign for accuracy at the beginning of the form and not at the end. The problem, this study was faked. Well-known is also a study claiming that eating chocolate supports weight loss. Of course, this would be beautiful, but it is wrong. Two journalists faked this study in order to identify possible problems of the science and publication systems. So what do German libraries do against fake science and predatory publishing? They reacted very fast on the temporary public outrage in July 2018 and published information on the websites. They organized coffee lectures, talks, and courses, and offer personal advice. Here are some of the best practice examples. In Germany, in Bamberg, we have a website, Quality Control in Journals, which gives information about open access and predatory journals. We present indicators that are a good sign that the journal is a reputable open access journal. For example, that is listed in the directory of open access journals. The publisher is a member of the Open Access Scholarly Publics Association or other well-recognized organizations. And we provide criteria that can be used to determine whether a journal is serious or not. Have your colleagues heard of the journal? Have you read any articles in this journal in the past? Who is in the editorial board? Are there well-known experts in the editorial board? Does the journal provide any details on the peer review process? Is there a correct ISSN? And does the publisher provide information on the cost for different services and when such are invoiced? We refer to the page Think, Check, Submit. All authors have to think first. Are they submitting a search to a trusted journal? They have to check the journal. And after that, it's a third step to submit an article. Here's the program of an open access week at Rostock University with the coffee lecture, How to Recognize Fake Science. Another example of a cover lecture, predatory publishing at a library in Mannheim. And finally, an example of an online workshop, predatory publishing during the research week 2021 at Bamberg University. These are events specifically on the topic of predatory publishing and fake science. Of course, that makes sense, but you will mainly reach a target group that is already at least rudimentary sensitized to this topic. More important and more effective is to include critical information literacy in every library course. Every library course must include not also the step search and find, but also the step check and evaluate. Let us use the new definition of information literacy of our English colleagues. Information literacy is the ability to think critically and make balanced judgments about any information we find and use. This is our goal, and the framework for information literacy for higher education may help us to achieve this goal. As you all know, the framework consists of the six frames. Authority is constructed and contextual. Scholarship is conversation. Information creation is a process. Information has value. Search as strategic exploration and research as inquiry. What are publicly relevant knowledge practices and dispositions for our goal, critical information literacy? The frame search as strategic exploration, for example, has this position. Realize that information sources have varying relevance and value. So let us discuss the relevance of information sources in every course. The framework information creation as a process has a knowledge practice. Evaluate information products usefulness. So let us check the background of any information sources in our courses. The frame authority is constructed and contextual, has this position, assess content with informed skepticism. So let us discuss the evaluation of every content we found in our courses. How can we do this in practice? When we are in a research course, let us choose a research example that results in a fake article. And then discuss quality criteria that characterize serious science. If we are in a library introduction and we present journals provided by the library, let us discuss quality criteria that characterize serious journals. If we are in an introduction in academic working methods, and we explain research strategies, let us discuss background research to check a publication. These are all examples how you can make students aware of fake science in basic introductory courses. I'm sure you know even more best practice, and I would like to discuss your experience and your ideas. Thank you very much.